SpaceX has cleared the final regulatory hurdle, standing before the inaugural launch of its Starship rocket, the most powerful rocket ever constructed. The Federal Aviation Administration, which licenses commercial rocket launches, announced Friday that it granted the company's request for an uncrewed flight test of the rocket out of the SpaceX facilities in South Texas. The vehicle, which has already undergone pre-flight ground testing, is poised to take off as soon as Monday. Starship set for orbital launch attempt, is FAA grant launch license. Let's discuss it today in this episode of Science of Space. After a comprehensive license evaluation process, the FAA determined SpaceX met all safety, environmental, policy, payload, airspace integration and financial responsibility requirements, the agency said in a statement. Earlier Friday, the FAA issued an air traffic restriction for the area surrounding the launch. The Notice to Air Missions, or NOTAM, orders planes and other air traffic to steer clear of the launch area, which lies due east of Brownsville, Texas, on Monday between 7 a.m. and 10:05 a.m. As a license has now been granted, there are few milestones that must occur for a launch on April 17. Ship 24 is yet to have been restacked onto Booster 7, since the flight termination system must be armed. In addition, an evacuation notice must be sent to residents before Starship can proceed with a launch attempt. To ensure safety for those nearby, temporary flight restrictions, a flight road closure, and a marine hazard notice are now all in place. These are released to ensure the safety of the public. In addition to everything else, SpaceX confirmed in an email that it will allow a C-credited press to set remote cameras about 500 feet away from the launch mount. Should result in some amazing photos, if the dust clouds aren't too awful smiley face. SpaceX also provide designated Starship launch viewing areas for local boaters. South Bay and Gulf waters south of Boca Chica Jetty will be closed Monday, and each day of launch attempt through the week if necessary. Red zone is keep out area. Please spread the word locals. This will be SpaceX's first attempt to put Starship into orbit, building on a years-long testing campaign to work out the design of the rocket. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has talked about Starship for about a decade, making elaborate presentations about its design and describing it as the vehicle that underpins SpaceX's founding purpose, sending humans to Mars for the first time. Additionally, NASA has already awarded SpaceX contracts and options, worth more than $3 billion, to use Starship to ferry government astronauts to the surface of the moon under the space agency's Artemis program. The inaugural flight test will not complete a full orbit around Earth. If successful, however, it will reach orbital speeds and travel about 150 miles above Earth's surface, well into altitudes deemed to be outer space. Starship consists of two parts, the Super Heavy Booster, a gargantuan rocket that houses 33 engines, and the Starship spacecraft, which sits atop the booster during launch, and is designed to break away after the booster expends its fuel to finish the mission. On this flight, the rocket booster will be discarded into the ocean shortly after liftoff. In future flights, however, SpaceX plans to recover the vehicle by guiding it to an upright landing back at the launch site. The Starship spacecraft will complete nearly one full lap of the planet, ending its flight with a splashdown off Hawaii. Development of Starship has been based at SpaceX's privately held spaceport about 40 minutes outside Brownsville, Texas, on the U.S.-Mexico border. Testing began years ago with brief, hop tests, of early spacecraft prototypes. The company began with brief flights, that lifted a few dozen feet off the ground, before evolving to high-altitude flights, most of which resulted in dramatic explosions, as the company attempted to land them upright. One suborbital flight test in May 2021, however, ended in success. Since then, SpaceX has also been working to get its Super Heavy booster prepared for flight. The massive, 230-foot-tall 69-meter-tall cylinder, is packed with 33 of the company's Raptor engines. Fully stacked, Starship and Super Heavy stand about 400 feet 120 meters tall. SpaceX has been waiting more than a year to get FAA approval for an orbital launch attempt. The company, and federal regulators tasked with certifying SpaceX launches won't pose risks to people or property in the area surrounding the launch site, have faced significant pushback from the local community, including from environmental groups. In June, the FAA granted SpaceX one key approval for launching Starship, though it laid out a list of mitigating actions the company would need to take before the first launch. During a call with reporters this week, an FAA official, who declined to be named for publication, said that the agency has been overseeing SpaceX's compliance with the mitigating actions, some of which are still in the works, even as the launch license is issued. The FAA official said government personnel will be on the ground to ensure SpaceX complies with its license during the test launch. The rocket's next major test, a hard task of launching to orbit for the first time, has been pushed back. Musk doubled down last year on the construction of Starship's launchpad at 39A in Florida's Cape Canaveral. "We do have the Cape launch tower as an alternative, and we actually applied for environmental approval for launch from the Cape a few years ago and received it," Musk said at a Starship update event in February, estimating it would take 6 to 8 months to build up the Cape launch tower and launch from there. However, preparations for Starship continue on the East Coast, both at the Roberts Road and LC-39A locations. A few months ago, Elon shared a render of how the Roberts Road complex will look once all significant work is done, and this cosmetic work can be seen on that same corner of the Hangar X building. It also shows the opening for vehicles to enter and exit. High Bay 3 will be on the north side, and the Starbase factory will feature two different roof heights, likely to accommodate nose cone and payload bay stacking. However, these plans appear to be somewhat fluid from a final design standpoint, with NSF's Harry Stranger spotting updated schematics of the Roberts Road factory plan, which could actually include two high bays. Development of the ground systems required to test and launch the spacecraft at 39A continues as usual. The large cryogenic tank at 39A is now more than double the height when we last flew, and construction has begun on another tank to the north of this new tank. "It seems to use a more traditional design due to the location, but I wouldn't do that. I'd be surprised if this is an additional methane tank, but we'll have to wait. Looks like it's on the south side of this tank." The newly upgraded hydrogen, which has recently been converted to a methane balloon, is completely white compared to the last flight and is now shiny. As the repairs progressed, a new set of transport lines was a good sign, stretching south of the methane tank field where the launch site was located. In satellite image 39A, we can see all of this progress from an orbital perspective, and we can see a new supercooler added next to the large cold tank, lending weight to the hypothesis that it is part of the LOX tank spacecraft farm. The blocking balls that SpaceX is currently using on 39A to launch the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy have not worked at all over the last month. It seems that there is another additional facility at the oil depot, similar to the one under construction in Boca Chica. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.